Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. It is so lovely to have you back here, and welcome back to this channel that's all about how to do map animation, at least if you're watching the videos from this week. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a map animation doing a dotted line instead of a normal line. I promised it's going to be the last map animation for quite a while on this channel. Anyway, if you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel a little bit more, you can push the join button down below and become a member of this channel. Also join the Facebook group, because it would be super cool to do a great community over there as well. With that out of the way, let's get right to the tutorial. Okay, so let's get right to this video. So I have this map, and actually I'm just going to jump into Fusion and do this map line animation. So what I have here is my media in and my media out. Okay, and I want to do this lined animation. And this is the only way I could figure out how to do that. If you don't want to do, of course, a normal line, in that case, you could see the video from Monday. But in this case, let's make a dotted line. And we're going to use a text node here. I'm just going to put in some lines here, like so. And then I'm going to drag the connector down to the media one, and I'm going to add in the merge node that way. And the thing we need to do now is we need to go into the layout. And in the layout, we're going to change it from point to path. And now we can simply draw in a path. So I'm going from Denmark here, all the way down here, traveling down to Australia, and then I'll go to Africa, and I'll go up to the UK and get a pint of beer there. So as you see right now, the path is not long enough, and that's simply because we do not have enough lines. So we'll just add in lines until it fits, like so. There we go. And let's change the color as well to a reddish color. I think that would be good. So now we actually want to animate our line here. And the way we could do that is by adding in a background node. And we're also going to create a mask, and that's going to be a polygon. And we're just going to connect those two together. And then I'm just going to put my background up at screen one by pushing one. And we're going to change the color as well. Let's say green, doesn't really matter. Okay, so now we want to do an animation, and with the polygon selected, I'm going over right here to click here to shape animation. I'm going to right click. And now I could, you know, I can't connect it to anything because per default it is already connected to this one, but I'm going to remove that like so. And since I did remove that, I can go into the text here and can change, or I can choose path, which is my text path right here. And you can see that in green, of course. So I'm going to go through the border width, and I'm going to make a border because it needs to be a little bit bigger, because I need to do the mask transition that way. Okay. So again, with the polygon selected, I can now drag this up to the blue input, which is a mask input, like so. And actually, I don't need the background anymore, so I can just take that away. So again, with the polygon selected, I'm just going to click invert to invert my selection. That just means that the red line is disappearing and going away. And now I need to animate this line on top of the red line so it will be visible. And we're going to do that right now. Again, with the polygon selected, I'll go to the beginning of my clip. And in the position, I'm just going to put this at 0. Then I'll go to wherever I want my clip to go. Let's say we can go to the end of the clip. And I'm just going to push this to 1. Okay, so here we have that animation going on. So if we want to add in a little bit of a finesse to our travel map here, we can actually do so by adding in some points. So let's say we want to have a point somewhere. Let's take a background width, and we're going to make this red. Then we're going to take a circle or an ellipse, and we're going to connect that. And I'm going to connect the background to merge 1. So I'll now have merge 2. So selecting the ellipse mask, and I'll go into the width and height. No, I can make it smaller. I can also just drag here to make it. If I push the control and use the middle mouse button, I can zoom in and I can move my dot here. And this needs to be way smaller. Something like that. Okay, so for instance, around here, I want it to appear. So if I put in a keyframe in the ellipse in the width and height, I'm going to use my arrow key going a couple of frames backwards, and I'm just going to change the width and the height to 0 so it disappears. And then, you know, it comes up here and it continues like that. And we can put in several points that way. So if you see this line here, it's because I didn't make my mask big enough, but I can change that very easily by going into the polygon and going into the border width. And I'm just going to make the border a little bit bigger. And now it's disappeared. Okay, so this is how you do a dotted line map effect inside of Fusion using the text key. And that's basically how you do this. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.